Hey, what's up, peeps? It's Pete Moriarty here. Great to be with you. If you are watching the replay, please say hello as well. Let me know where you're watching from, whether you're on Facebook or YouTube or LinkedIn or wherever you're checking this out. Please make sure you say hello. My name is Pete Moriarty and I'm the owner of IT Genius. We are a company that helps small businesses with their technology, and something that we are really, really good at is helping businesses with Google Cloud and specifically G Suite. Now, we've helped thousands of businesses across Australia and beyond all over the world help get their teams more productive and help business owners do more inside and outside of the business by using pretty cool tech from Google to make everything run nice and smoothly. And so this session is going to be focused for those that are already using G Suite. So if you're already a G Suite user, I'm going to be showing you some cool stuff that you can do inside of it that most people have not quite ticked all of the boxes inside the Google G Suite. Now, why is it important that we cover off this stuff? Why is it important that I teach and reteach and reteach and reteach the cool things that you can do inside G Suite? Well, that's because you want to get the most out of your investment in a piece of technology like this. If you've put this in your business, you want to make sure you're actually using it. We hear from many business owners that they come to us and they say, hey, I set up this Google thing, or someone else set up this Google thing for me, and I don't really fully know what it does.
Might help if I bring my microphone around. Okay, so now we have audio. I think we're good now. But the reason that we're putting together this video is for those that are already on G Suite to help you get a bit more out of the platform. It's super important that you make sure that your investment is realized by you using all of the features of this application. Now, is this about ticking boxes? No, it's not about ticking boxes. This is actually about you and your team being the most productive that they can be, which is our job as consultants and advisors. And so we want to help you unleash the power of the tools that you already have. Now, we were on a call with the guys at Google today, our friends down in Sydney. Shout out to Tim if you're listening to the stream or watching the replay. And what they said was businesses that adopt G Suite and the Google Cloud ecosystem can have individual team members or workers save literally hours per day thanks to the features built into Google. So we've got AI and machine learning starting to be built in. We've got, you know, all the basic collaboration features working in real time instead of working linearly and saving stuff and waiting for it to synchronize. We're no longer attaching documents to email, documents in our live and working inside the Google ecosystem. And so all these things together will literally save workers hours every single day in the way that they work. And these are from studies that are conducted by consulting companies who go into large organizations and measure how teams actually work, comparing different alternative collaboration platforms to the Google ecosystem. So I want to help you unleash that. I want to help you get some of that, helping you and your team to be more productive. So that's what the point of this session is. The first one I want to share with you, and if you're already a concierge customer of ours, you should have got an email about this in the last week or so, is that Meet has now been switched on. Well, Meet recording has now been switched on inside of Google Meet. And it's basically cloud-based recording right inside your meetings. And I've been talking a lot about this and hammering on and on about it because it's really important that you have a go at this, because it's free for now, but only for a limited time. After the end of September, you'll have to actually be on an enterprise account to get access to this recording feature. But let me tell you, once you've used this, it's really hard to go back. So I implore you to have a crack at trying this out right now. So what does that look like? Well, when we're inside a meeting here, and I'm going to switch to my meeting where we have Angel here as well. How you doing, Angel? And inside the Google Meet, in my settings, in the bottom right-hand corner here, I just need to click a little button and I've got an option there to record the meeting. And what this does is it's automatically going to start recording the meeting. I've got to, you know, accept and ask for consent, and it's going to let everyone on the meeting know that I'm actually recording the meeting. But in true Google fashion, this is going to record to the cloud automatically. And so that means that I don't have to like download a file afterwards. I don't have to mess around with the recording or kind of dig around with anything. Now, what I like about this is once it's finished recording, it's automatically going to just drop that straight into my Google Drive. So if I open up my Google Drive here, you can see I've got a folder called Meet Recordings, and all my recordings just basically drop straight into there automatically. Now, not only will the videos be recorded, but also any text that is in there as well. And so all of those are being basically captured into recordings automatically, and it automatically shares the recording with any of the participants that were on the video as well. So that's a nifty little feature, really, really useful for the following: recording important critical meetings where you don't want to have to worry about like firing firing up screen share, or if you're using something like Zoom, you've got to like download it to your computer and then remember to upload it. Or if you're using the cloud storage feature in Zoom, it eventually fills up and you run out of space. This is just like one click, bang, it's recording, and then you don't have to worry about it anymore. The second thing that this is really useful for is because it's automatically saving them into Google Drive, what that means is you can just drag and drop from that Google Drive folder to maybe your training folder or a staff folder or maybe an HR file if it's like an HR type meeting, and you don't have to worry about downloading and re-uploading the file. It's already stored on the cloud and you can just move it about whenever you need to. Can also be used for recording maybe a client meeting. And so if you're using it for a client meeting, you can first record and then easily share that with someone just via a link, because it's automatically gonna share any participants that were on the video access to the meeting. So that makes it really easy to get access to everything there. Now, it records everything that happens in the meeting, including the video, obviously, but also the chat that I mentioned. And it just puts the chat into a text file. The one thing that it doesn't record are the captions. And so I'll show you what they look like. You can switch on captions inside your Google Meetings now, again, just down from the settings menu. And so once you're in a Google Meet, it should automatically start transcribing. So once you're inside a Google Meet, it's automatically going to transcribe your voice to text. Unfortunately, it doesn't save that in the recordings. However, there are some third-party plugins for Google Meet which will allow you to do that. So there you go, a little pro tip if you didn't know that they were available there inside of Google Meet. There's cool little transcriptions that you can switch on automatically. So that's Google Meet. I'm really curious to know from you guys, because we talk to a lot of businesses and many are in the Zoom world because everyone kind of went Zoom when COVID happened. And some are still like using Skype or another kind of video conferencing app. I'm really curious to hear from you. Drop in the comments, what is the app you use the most? Now, don't worry, no judgment here at all. I'm just really curious to know, have you started using Google Meet more than something like Zoom? Or are you still a Zoomer? Because I'm curious to know, you know, we've really been on a campaign to try and get more and more business owners using Meet, because there's no extra cost. It's going to be more secure because it's tied to your Google account. It's really convenient because it's built in and integrated with all the other Google apps, and it automatically talks to Google Calendar, and there's captions and recording and all the other cool features. But I know that a lot of our customers still use Zoom just because they're kind of in the habit of that. So drop down below in the comments, what is the primary, no judgment, what is the primary video app that you're using right now? Are you using Zoom? Are you using Skype? Are you using Teams or Slack? Or some business owners I know use Facebook chat because it's just really easy to chat to people on Facebook. Drop that down below and I'd love to hear what that is.